Hey guys, this is Mike Sygula from TruthTheory.com, and today's topic is intentions. I think it is a very overlooked subject, but extremely important. Every day, whatever decisions we make, we have some kind of intentions behind these decisions, and they really create a blueprint for how we attract people and situations. So let me give you some examples. Let's say you want to start a business. Let's say you are a chef and you are passionate about cooking. And maybe, you know, you want to start a restaurant. And this is fine. You're doing it because you have some deep passion. So what happens is that you start attracting people, you know, situations, maybe business partner, maybe employees, maybe customers, etc., etc., etc. All these different people very likely will have a blueprint which has to match your intentions. So you might attract, for example, employee that will be also very passionate about what they do. But on the other hand, you could start a business, let's say, you want to start a business because the niche or industry is suddenly becoming profitable. Like, for example, cannabis industry in Canada, which is, you know, since for the last 2 or 3 years, they legalized cannabis. So it suddenly opens in completely new industry. And you think like, okay, this is a perfect time because it's going to be profitable and you want to join. And you have no idea about cannabis, you are not interested in cannabis, you just do it for the money, right? So, because of your intentions behind it, you start attracting people, situations that hold the same blueprint. So, for example, you might attract a business partner who will be only interested in money, ego-driven, you know, and that's going to create all sorts of situations, you know, things like, whenever something's going to go wrong, he might be the first to kick you out or sell his shares or whatever. On the other hand, in case of the guy with a restaurant, whenever something goes wrong, because, you know, everyone there is passionate about what they do, they will try to help him. So I'm talking about his employees, for example. So intentions are extremely important. You know, we have intentions every day with everything. Let me give you another example. I heard about this guy who was manifesting a well-paid job. So basically his intention was to make more money. It wasn't so much about being happy in the new job. It was more about having well-paid job, better paid than the current one he had. So what happened was that he manifested the job, he got the job, but at the same time, you know, he was getting more money as he wanted, but he had more responsibilities, it was a lot more stressful, he had to work extra hours, weekends, evenings, answering phones late at night, all this kind of stuff. So in the end, he was actually more stressed and more unhappy, even though he got what he wanted. So here is another example of intentions, how they attract patterns, you know? Intention is like a blueprint. It basically starts attracting things towards you that hold the same frequency. So another example, you know, let's say you want to have a girlfriend. And what are your intentions behind having a girlfriend? You know, do you genuinely just want to be in love and share your life with someone? Or do you want to have a hot girl because your friend's going to, you know, think that you are incredible or whatever? Or do you want to have a girl just for sex or, you know, anything? What are your intentions behind it? And based on that, you will start attracting people who will have the same frequency. So let's say you have some expectations that, let's say you want to have a hot girl that is, you know, really good looking. It's fine, but what might happen is that you will attract someone who will also have some kind of, desires or intentions towards their potential partner, which will hold the same frequency. So it could be that, for example, she's only interested in money. And the interesting thing is that, let's say you have money, you're making good money, whatever, but once something goes wrong, the intentions are not met and she disappears because now you're not fulfilling her intentions. So it's really, really important. Every single day we make decisions and they all are based on intentions. So let's say you want to help someone. Are you helping this person because genuinely you want to help this person? Or is it because you are expecting something in return? So all these things create some kind of blueprint and you start attracting things that resonate with your intentions. So keep that in mind. Whatever it is that you're doing, whenever you make any decisions. And if you like this video, please subscribe, share, and like, comment, whatever. I want to know what's your views about these ideas.